Bloggo's POW.
Okay, it's time to have a look at a few licensed games which came maybe a little bit too late. Right, so first off we have Battlestar Galactica. That's right, you know that TV series that wanted to be Star Wars, and didn't George Lucas try and sue them at one point?
He did, just because they used all the same design artists and musicians.
That's right, they did, didn't they? They pretty much said, let's take Star Wars and give it a budget cut, and came up with Battlestar Galactica. And I'm sure I've probably upset loads of Battlestar Galactica fans just by saying that, but hey, suck it up, guys.
And Battlestar Galactica TV was 1978.
1978, yeah.
And this and game
was released in
2004.
Okay, so
slightly late with the license.
But hey, you know, nostalgia sells sometimes.
Yeah.
To the six people who remember it.
And it was probably cashing in on the mini series of the reboot, which I think had come out by now. Right, so what have we got? But all the visuals in this are based on classic Galactica, which, as everyone knows, is the best Galactica.
Flight manual? Nah.
No, just go!
So, yes, cutscene, Battlestar Galactica. Right. So, CGI representations of people. Question is, will Starbuck and Apollo look like Starbuck and Apollo? If that's supposed to be them, I'm really upset because...
I think this is set in the original Cylon War, so before the 78 series.
Oh, right, okay.
So you got young Adama and Starbuck's relative.
Right. Yeah, I'm sure this is probably important. We're being attacked by Cylons.
Basically, yeah. Kill the Cylons.
Kill Paulus!
Yeah.
Okay, this is pretty standard space controls.
Yeah. You're in your Mark 1 Viper. Press Y, I think it is, to lock on target. Or locate.
Lead on your controls are a little bit twitchy. That's why I'm going full back with the analog sticks here, and I'm getting clicking. Luckily, they come to bits easy.
Yeah. You know what though? I'm a little bit disappointed already because there was no launch sequence. I mean, what's Battlestar Galactica without a launch sequence?
Yeah. Make our own sequence of blackjack and hookers.
Yeah.
But yeah, good job these signals come to bits easy.
Yes. And flicking through the manual, back when games had manuals, see they've actually got the voice actors of Dirk Benedict in it.
Oh yes.
And Richard
Hatch, RIP. Yep.
And even Dwight Schultz.
Who wasn't in it.
He was
in the 80.
He was, yeah.
With Dirk Benedict. You can imagine that conversation. Yeah. Hey there. George is dead, but do you want to come on my TV show?
Yeah.
Wait, that's not a TV show, it's a video game. Ah, what the hell, what do you care? You've been in Star Trek.
You done anything since Star Trek? No.
Nope. Was in an episode of Voyager. Oh. Dwight Schultz, say it's not Dirk Benedict. Was Dirk Benedict ever in an episode of Star Trek?
I don't think so.
Oh, Simon speaking.
Kamikaze Cowboy, Dirk Benedict.
Was that Battle Beyond the Stars? Nah, did have George in part, didn't it?
It's all linked.
Like some kind of global conspiracy.
Yeah.
Maybe perpetrated by the Cylons.
Hmm. Oh, have you got like a thrust button on your Viper so you can go extra fast?
It goes fast-ish. As soon as I've pressed the Cylon, I'll use it. Look, here we go. Here we go. We can do it.
Do the thrust. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, well, it's not particularly fast. Oh, cutscene.
But I was a big fan of Galactica back in the 1980s.
Do you know what? I saw that. Because obviously the pilot was shown over here was in the cinema as a movie. I remember seeing that. I remember not catching the show regularly. It seemed to be one of those things, at least on regional television, was they fucked about the schedules.
Yeah, and it depended on what region you were in, you may get to see it or you may never see it.
Or you might see the episodes out of order or whatever.
Yeah.
Your mum's taking fire from all sides. Oh, fuck's sake, just look onto it and shoot it.
Yeah. But yeah, 1980, I would have loved a game like this. But
1980, this would have blown our minds. Yeah. We wouldn't even have Spectrums and Commodore 64s.
But I did see recently, actually, there was a handheld Battlestar Galactica game came out.
Well, like the Tiger electronics.
Like Bandai.
Yeah, which, LED sort of things.
Which also would have been amazing.
Yeah, 1980. True. I don't think I had one of the. No, I don't think I actually had any video game systems in 1980.
No.
I think I got a black and white Binatone thing. Probably around about. Or maybe a couple of years later, maybe 82.
I think I had a handheld by that point. I had just a Championship Racer or something.
Anyway, we've gone really off topic.
We totally twatted those Cylons.
Yeah, fucked off right back to Cylonia or wherever the fuck they come from.
Yes, and we can do cool Viper flying formation. So I think we should go back to Galactica for some socialating and probably some future space dancing.
Yeah, like in Buck Rogers.
Yeah.
Am I defending the asteroid or blowing the crap out of it?
I would go for blowing it up and then
then deal with the aftermath later. Yeah, okay, cool. Well, I suppose you can't really go too wrong if you're taking on the if you shoot the Cylons.
Yeah. Have you got missiles?
I have a missile, yeah. Look, there it goes.
Yeah, cool.
Bye. Got a bit of a blast radius. Shit, there's a rock there. Fuck, where did that come from?
It wasn't just a big piece of space, it was actually a
big
asteroid.
Big piece of what? Yeah, sound effects are cool though.
Yeah, I think they've gone for classic sound effects.
Pew pew pew. Classic Battlestar Galactica sound effects.
But the problem with space games is they can become quite repetitive. It's just.
Yeah, I mean.
Chasing in circles.
It is. But sometimes you. I mean, one to work. Well, not necessarily a space game, but a game like this that works really well is Secret Weapons over Normandy. Which, ironically, you can fly as an X-Wing.
Oh, cool. But not a Viper.
But not a Viper, no.
Having a flick through the manual, it looks like they've got a whole range of missions, so your usual stuff. Quite a few different classes of Cylons been made up. Yeah, so hopefully it'll have quite a bit of variety.
I love this, that's the way they thought aliens would speak, through like a Casio voice modulator or something.
I wonder if you can get a Cylon thing for Alexa, that would be good.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
Alexa, invade Earth.
Yeah.
The live immortal. I know those little hunts.
Got that one.
And that one. Yeah, so yeah, this is pretty good.
Yeah, there's quite a bit going on for space action.
Missiles, Comsat, missiles.
Yeah.
Yeah, that twatted in.
Cutscenes are looking a bit dated now.
Yeah.
But, yeah, the sound effects, the ships look good. You're hitting the asteroid again.
Oh, shit. Whoa, battle roll, did you see that?
Yeah.
No idea how I did that. It was awesome.
Try a roll.
Try a bow roll.
Hey.
Powerful.
Ah.
Well, there we go. Yes. Buck Rogers. I mean, no. Battlestar Galactica.
Needs more launch sequences, but apart from that, it's seems pretty solid.
Yeah.
Also, this is the Xbox version we're playing, but it did come on the PS2.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Oh, lock on. Lock the missiles on, that's cool.
It'd be good if the little Cylons appeared in the corner when they spoke, just because they look cool.
Yeah, that would be cool.
Pow.
Well,
got that.
There we go.
Right.
That's Star Galactica. Let's just use the lock on this Cylon radar. Twatted. Yeah, this is good stuff. Enjoying this. If I see this lurking around somewhere, I will definitely pick it up.
Yeah, great.
Since this is your copy.
Yeah, it is. And if you see the original Battlestar Galactica series lurking around, pick that up on DVD.
Totally.
But not Galactica 80.
No, that's shit.
Yeah.
So, second off, we have Codename Robotech. Codename Robotech? Yep. That's the video. Robotech Battlecry.
Okay, so Robotech was released American cartoons. Well, I say American. Yeah. a series of cartoons released in America in 84?
Well, the 85. Original was...
Original's 82.
82, yeah. At least Macross was 82. This gets very confusing really quickly, and we could probably waffle on about this for a few hours.
A video in itself is the history of Robotech.
Robotech was three anime series stuck together with Super Glue by a mad American. End of.
And it wasn't shown on UK TV until the early 90s.
No, it was on cable over here.
Yeah.
But I never had cable, but it was shown on cable.
And this game, what year was it?
2002!
So again, 20 years.
20 years late.
And also the wrong country, because nobody in the UK really knows what Robotech is.
No, apart from us.
Apart from us, yeah.
Yeah, because we're like nerds. Yeah. Story mode. Chapter 1, Booby Trap. Now, Booby Trap was an episode of the original series. Mm. So,
let's go. Oh, we've got a couple of different designs, haven't you? For anyone who knows Robotech, you've got some classic designs.
I'm always going to go with the trainer version, in the trainer colours, the beige and orange, because that was the first robot model kit I had with this, was that?
Of course, in the UK, the Macross kits were popular in the early 80s.
You could get them in normal model shops.
Yeah.
Again, we really probably need to make a video all about Macross.
Yeah, we're going to need to stop talking about Macross and try and focus on the game.
Play the game, yes.
Yeah. My name
is Jack Archer. Hello, Jack Archer.
Jack Archer. He's just invented for this game, so he doesn't count.
He's not canon, so when he dies in this, nobody in the anime actually cares. Yep. Okay.
It's a bit more flying and shooting.
So, again, we've just played Battlestar Galactica, so...
Similar kind of thing. At any minute now, we'll see a transformation.
I'm gonna transform...
I don't think you can until...
Until I get
cleared this bit. And this is another cel-shaded graphics type game, which is actually pretty close to the animation.
Yeah, it is. Nice. It's very well designed. It is a good approximation of the look of the cartoon.
Need lock on missiles, I think.
Yeah, I'm sure I can.
Let me see if I can find the...
Whoa, shit!
Oh, you did transform.
I'm a robot, awesome.
Switch to Gerwok configuration.
I don't even know how to switch to Battleoid configuration.
Oh, right, don't worry then.
Oh, sniper mode.
That's good.
Okay, so what we'll do is we'll...
We'll
skip forward. Yeah, we'll skip forward to ground bit. It's a bit more interesting on the ground. These aerial dogfights are a little bit bare, and the game does look better when it's on the ground. This test stand one controls So, yeah, we're on to a grand mission.
Yep.
We've got to protect some stuff in Makros City.
We've got to drive out the invading Zentradi.
How do I actually move forward? And it's cool because it's got the Robotech music.
Yeah.
And visually, this is a lot like Transformers Devastation.
Yeah, it is. Which
several years later.
Well, about 10 years later. Yeah. I think Transformers Devastation was 2014?
Yeah, it was early in the Xbox One. PS4
one.
Line.
Yeah.
Switch to.
Yeah, not Android. Blake.
There we go. Yeah, that's more like it. Oh, yes. Take out another building.
Class all damage!
There's been quite a few Robotech games over the years, hasn't there?
There's a
Game Boy Advance one.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
Horizontal.
Sideways scrolling shooter.
Yeah. Robotech Invasion, which came after this, I think.
Yeah, I think I didn't play. I haven't played Invasion.
Yeah, it's based on the third segment of Robotech.
Mospedia, isn't it? Yeah.
So it's all about transforming motorbikes.
Oh, I appear to be stuck.
Uh-oh.
Change modes, Mac. Gotcha.
Yeah. And there was the cancelled N64 Robotech game.
Oops. Oh yeah, Crystal Dreams.
Yeah.
Or whatever it's called.
Oh no, you smashed through the building, that's nice.
I'm also stuck again. There we go.
Looks like they let a civilian pilot a Battleoid.
Yeah, what's going on with that?
And
oh, the explosion is really cool in this.
Hmm. Oh, and in case you're wondering, there are enemy pilots inside the enemy vehicle, so they're not robots, you are killing sentient beings.
That's right. It's murder,
hey,
I kids. Tell you.
More as hell.
That Macross had quite a heavy anti-war message, didn't it?
It did, yeah.
Something that had lots and lots of robots shooting shit.
Not robots.
Yeah, okay.
We don't know where the school is.
Yeah, I think I just blew the school up.
Yeah.
Oh!
Missile
points.
Barrel roll.
Yeah, and it got me out of trouble. But I know I can't turn around.
No quick turn on this. Can you use your missiles in Battleoid mode?
No.
Oh.
It makes your rifle rapid fire though.
Ah, that's good.
I think it's probably the thing I should probably do myself is actually trying.
Yeah.
So yes.
This is on again Xbox and PS2
and GameCube.
GameCube as well.
And GameCube, yes.
Another
licensed game for all three major formats.
Quite a big budget game at the time, I think.
Yeah, and also a really, really strange one because, again, in this country, Tommy said earlier, Robotech wasn't particularly well known.
But, yeah, a welcome game anyway.
And the irony is, it was published in this country by TDK, you know, the people who make tapes, video cassettes,
yes.
And we used to copy Robotech onto TDK tapes.
Yeah, all the time.
Yeah. Oh, the irony!
Yes,
but yeah, worth picking up if you find it.
On
any of the formats.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
cool.
Knight Rider, a A shadowy flight into the dangerous world of a man who does not exist. Michael Knight, a young loner on a crusade to champion the cause of the innocent, the helpless, the powerless, in a world of criminals who operate above the law.
Right, after that absolutely ridiculous intro.
It's brilliant. Ready for some Knight Rider.
Oh my god, before you started this, you said you've not played this, I've not played this. And you said, what would we expect from a Knight Rider game? Then that intro came on. Oh, Christ on my life.
He wasn't expecting that.
Right, so yeah, Knight Rider, this is going to be special. Yeah. Worth noting, this is developed by Davilex, and Davilex are well known for the M25 series of racers.
Are they?
Yeah.
So I'd expect a Chase HQ style game from the Knight Rider. Lots of chasing cars, turbo boosting, and running people off the road.
Yeah.
And then a badly digitized Michael Hasselhoff at the end of each level.
David Hasselhoff.
David Michael.
David Knight.
You're going to drive in the back of the van, probably.
Well done.
Yes.
They're going to force a tutorial upon us.
Oh no. Oops.
We'll slowly reverse out to the truck.
First mission, get out the truck.
You were reversing a minute ago.
I don't know what went wrong.
Put it in H. Do I do a 3-point turn?
Yeah. I think I've got the handbrake on.
There we go.
Finally. Ooh, well, actually, it's quite fast handling.
Okay, cool. Yes.
I don't know where I'm going.
There's an arrow.
Oh, there's an arrow. Is that my?
Oh, there's a wall. There's a map there as well.
Oh, great. Kit sat nav.
Cat nav. And they've got rumble strips on the side. Oh, they did say this was the training track. So.
Ah, right. Ah, oh, don't want to do all the training.
Well, I'll tell you what, do we cut to chase, literally. Yeah. Hopefully a chase. Okay, cool. Let's do that.
I didn't want to play Super Monkey Ball.
So, we have just sat through 20 minutes of absolute bullshit training involving jumping, scanning, side wheelies and shit like that, and it was painful.
And we probably won't even use them for most of the levels.
No.
But the kit looks cool. Story.
Strange things are afoot at the Circle K.
Bad truck.
Gonna man-made somebody.
That train's paid off.
I knew you were gonna hit that.
Remember, I'm the worst at driving.
And also remember, you're in America, so you're driving on the other side of the road.
It's crazy.
Whoa!
Everything's blowing up.
So yes, now we're getting a bit Chase HQ now.
This is more like it. Things
blowing up. Got that mine.
Ooh. Got a lot of mines about.
More ship blowing up.
Civilians in towards me.
Whoa. Nothing like more collateral damage.
Yeah.
Yes.
No. Turbo boosting is...
Whoa!
not a good idea.
No, is it? Can't turbo boost it over the top.
That could have driven through that sign there, though.
So, now we're onto the game proper. What are your thoughts?
This is kind of what I was hoping it would be like. Certainly don't want to be doing any navigating around
trees.
I don't want to be going around cities. Whoops, which I think you probably will have to do in later levels.
Yeah.
I think he's probably going to be way too far ahead.
The whole thing is, though, is it's just not, in my opinion, the pain of the training mission. This isn't a good payoff.
No, I think it will get a bit more exciting later on. What? Oh, there was rocks behind the smoke.
That's handy.
In spite of my molecular bondage, these mines hurt.
We should try. Oh, you've got a damage meter!
Damage. Yeah.
I didn't notice you got a damage meter.
We actually driven in a big circle. I think we might have done.
He's a really shitty getaway driver. Yeah. Should have just driven in a circle.
I've not caught him yet. Anyway, what year did this game come out?
Shit! Turbo boost
and brake at the same time.
I don't know. I can't remember what it said now.
2002, I think. Knight Rider was big in
84,
earlier, 83,
82, 83.
Yeah,
maybe we should have done some research. That was cool.
Mm. But in the region I lived, you had a choice between watching Knight Rider or Tales of the Golden Monkey.
Oh,
which was
right.
A tough choice.
Yes. Well done indeed. The
robbers and the money are both. Yes, I didn't even touch
well done.
Him.
He just chased him into a police roadblock.
Yeah.
And now the police have arrested you for being a vigilante.
Yeah.
And lastly, we have Masters of the Universe, He-Man, Defender of Crayfish.
Yep.
So, of course, He-Man was really big in what, really early 80s? 82?
No, maybe 83, I think.
Yeah, I think it's about right, about 83.
Or maybe 82, 83.
I know it coincided with the end of the Star Wars craze. So.
Yes, yeah.
Okay, cool.
And this game is, I think, 2003. So again, 20 years.
Late.
And
oh, dear.
This is not my He-Man.
I want my real He-Man. This one's rubbish.
Yeah, although really I was too old for He-Man. Said he wanted a younger man.
What the fuck's that?
Training robot, I imagine. Things PS2 games love is training modes.
Yeah.
That one might have been a story.
Right. New attack.
Backspin. Mash some buttons.
So here is He-Man, the master of the universe, and he appears to be in a prison, but
locked
with his
in
sword.
A cell. Yeah. So that was a. Major oversight by some minion.
Yeah.
Get out. That robot is gloating at the fact he's locked you up.
So much it to just duck to it. Oh, break part of the wall. This part? Well, that part that's slightly
part,
colored differently.
Ha!
He's laughing now, robot. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Try and play the game by using the controller.
No idea where I'm supposed to be going.
Games assume you've never played a game before in your life.
Yeah. Try using your eyes to see the surroundings. I need the control room key. Wait, how many keys do I need?
Yeah.
Smash some shit up and...
I prefer it when games just throw you into the action.
Yeah,
and
you can
figure it out for yourself.
Absolutely.
At least the first level of a game should be like maximum excitement, and then it can tone it back down.
Yeah.
But you don't really want to start a game sitting in a dungeon with nothing happening.
And telling you roughly what you really,
you
know, should come naturally to a point.
Yeah. Ha! Take that box. Vase.
No, can't hit that. He-Man does not interact with things. He hits them with his sword.
Ah, the key.
Control room key, which is down the other end of the corridor. This isn't particularly interesting, really.
I think maybe they do these really long introductory levels just to make the game longer. Well, that was nice and fast.
There's a dude behind me. Red robots are full part easy.
Yeah. Oh, there's some secret pickup. The He-Man the cartoon had loads of crazy vehicles and stuff in it, didn't it? And flying vehicles and stuff. So
yeah.
I didn't really watch it much.
It was quite a bit of it. I downloaded the whole series of BitTorrent. I mean, a legal download site.
Oh, right, yeah.
At one point. And it was a lot of it. It was on Netflix at one point.
Yeah, I do remember it was on that.
What I always remember about the TV series is the moral of the week at the end of each episode. Things like be nice to people and that. And then one episode, I'm pretty sure they run out of ideas because Tila popped up and went, be nice to trees. Trees are our friends. Be nice to trees.
But trees are living things. And when you respect a tree, you show that you care about all life.
And that actually was this one on the end of an episode. I'm totally going to put that in here.
You should find that. Do you think there'll be a moral at the end of this? I think there'll be a lesson to be learned.
There's already a lesson to be learned. If a game looks like it might be a little bit of a nostalgia kick and it's cheap in a charity shop or a boot fair, there's probably a good reason it's there.
Yeah. Are you able to switch to your axe? Have you picked up an axe?
Does he have an axe?
He does have an axe. He probably had an axe, didn't he?
Did he?
First one.
April.
But we haven't even seen Skeletor yet.
No, you would have thought he would have been cackling around.
He could have at least come and laughed at He-Man.
He-Man, you muscle-headed fool!
You've been practicing your Skeletor.
I'm so good at Skeletor, aren't I?
Ooh. Oh, you got killed by a wall.
He-Man! You're a twat! You're a fucking retard, He-Man!
You need the acid pit key. Who has an acid pit key? Shit, I've locked myself out my acid pit. Oh, my God. Oh, no.
And now we don't. Whoa, what the fuck?
That wall is dangerous.
Are
you going the right way?
I'm probably going the wrong way now to find my acid pit key.
Is there a map?
I don't know, but there's
a sharp box.
Sharp box. You see, the thing is this acid pit key could be in anything that's destructible around the level, and I've already lost track of exactly where I am or I'm not going, because everything looks identical.
And it's too dark as well.
It is very dark, isn't it? Let's press some burner buttons. Oh, we got a jump button.
Have you got a map?
No. Got a block button.
Oh, that's handy.
I tell you what I don't have is a to the power of Grayskull button.
Ah. Definitely need that.
Oh, there it is. The acid pit key!
He never said that in the cartoon series.
I think he should have done.
Can you remember the way to the acid pit?
No.
Oh.
I'm just kidding. Oh, yeah, this is
that very dangerous wall.
Oh, shit. Really? Ow. And it... Oh, for fuck's sake, it spawns you in exactly the same place.
You don't seem to have any life limit, so...
I don't know, there's a nice big zero in the middle of that sword.
Oh, alright, so we might be mercifully short then. Watch out for this door. I need to see the acid pit. Yes!
Wow.
Wow. Well, They probably did need a key for it.
Yeah, there's your acid pit.
Yeah.
Fantastic. I don't hit buttons. Well, I do.
I know
literally.
Buttons. No use for buttons. Where's Battle Cat?
Where's Battle Cat? Where's Skeletor?
Could have started the game.
I mean, for fuck's sake, where's Beast Man?
Yeah. Could have started the game riding on Battle Cat into a horde of enemies.
Yeah. Dynasty Warriors style.
Yeah.
I didn't even know.
Or locked in a brown dungeon of brownness.
Nothing says He-Man like a brown dungeon.
He could use. Oh, but it's extremely lethal.
Fuck!
I think this is going to be the end very shortly.
He-Man! Behold my thrusting rods of doom!
So you've already improved the game.
I have. I should have been doing the fucking voiceovers for this.
Go! Now! Stop!
Actually, this isn't actually. Oh fuck!
Yeah.
Oh shit! And I'm being attacked by robots.
Yay! I think you did that on purpose.
It's immersively short.
Yeah.
There's only one thing to say at the end of that.
Welcome to bonus.
So, next up, we have Transformers.
This one was 2004, so before Bayformers and all that nonsense.
When did the Bayformers start? 2005, 2006?
Around 2006,
I think.
Yeah,
so this was when Transformers still had a shred of decency at the time.
Yeah.
There was a couple of reboots. I mean, Beast Wars had happened.
Possibly
another animated series.
But it certainly wasn't mainstream at this point.
No, it wasn't like...
I remember people were quite excited about this game at the time.
It got good reviews. It was written by Melbourne House.
Yeah, who did Spectrum and
Commodore 64 games. Where'd Exploding Fist? And Where'd Exploding Fist?
Yeah.
Fist 2.
Some other stuff.
I can't remember what else they did.
All very peaceful here.
I seem to remember the whole thing with this one. It mentioned the minicons in the intro. But the odd thing is to find the minicons to do something. I can't remember what sort of rebuilding thing or something.
Yeah, complete the level.
And here comes some cannon fodder Decepticons.
Yep. They won't last long.
Because you can't kill off all the good ones. Well, unless it's Transformers the movie, in which case, anybody's game, I suppose. And here we go.
Okay, some more transforming robot fun.
Sort of third person shootery sort of thing. Activate that. Whatever that is. Well done. Optimus Prime is happy.
Use warp gates. Alright.
Oh, actually, that's for saving. Okay, cool.
Save point. How do you think we transform?
Shoulder button, maybe?
No. Oh, there we go.
Well, excellent. That is really unpractical for driving around the Amazon in.
Definitely a good choice. Doesn't seem to be a map anywhere.
No. I think probably we'd be better off in robot mode. I think that cliff face to the left. Oh, yeah, that cliff face there. I think that's probably a way forward. Oh, first person. It's definitely. This just looks like a path. Specifically.
Should be a jump button.
Specifically carved out for. You by the game developers.
Ah, there we are. Jump is left shoulder, which is a bit weird.
That's weird. That's a strange place to put a left shoulder button.
And it actually vibrates the pad as you run along, so you're getting a feeling of weight.
Cool. It's good to have the big stompy robot games with a actual feeling of weight.
I think I missed an urgent message then.
Look out, Decepticon! Shoot it in the face!
Bam!
Whoa! Came to bits easy.
Take that.
The Decepticlones have found a... Blah, blah, blah.
Blah,
some
blah,
stuff
blah.
Happened.
Do Beautiful. Some work. God, chores. It's always the same with Prime.
I know. He just won't shut up. He's so overbearing.
Yeah, whatever. Gotcha. Left one went to recon mode.
Don't do recall mode, just run in and shoot shit.
Good plan. Wait, why run? When I can transform.
Oh, that's right. I think you've got the touch, etc, etc. Yeah. You've got the power. Pow. Just run into him. Boom. There you go.
Excellent.
Learn that move and transforms the movie.
Right, I'm gonna, whoops, try and, whoa, invert the y-axis maybe. I'll try and take down this ship.
Well, the reticle goes red when you shoot at it, so it's probably taking damage.
Oh, I think I've run out of gun juice.
Or is it slowing down?
Mm.
Oh, I see, there's a charge bar at the top there, which goes down as you shoot, and then recharges when you let go.
I've got any rockets.
No, but you can transform into a car.
Yeah.
What's that green thing?
I don't know, that might be my objective. Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I bet there's a minicon inside.
Yep, that was my objective. Good
work. He's got a really big rocket launcher for his body.
It's kind of cool.
Right, attached to R2 button.
Yeah.
Quick, test them out. Shoot them and stuff.
Yes, it's like a missile launcher.
Great. Now awesome. Can you down that Decepticon drop shot?
Oh, there it is.
Chase it. Well, that's obviously what you're supposed to do.
Such a chore to walk.
Waha!
Shit. I'm glad I'm a racing car in a jungle.
Oh, set cool. Creeps. That was pretty cool. Would have been slightly less cool if you'd fallen off the bridge. Like that.
What, jump again?
Oh, L2, another, I think you said.
Another one.
I think it's a save point.
Oh, yeah. Alright. It'd be cool to drive across this bridge in a car mode.
Except it's broken. I don't think the Aztecs had it in mind. I don't think they had giant robots, let alone race cars. Mind you, they were probably, I don't know, aliens anyway, the Aztecs. Maybe they were Transformers, who knows? Yeah, I'm not going
to
get
out. I'm not going to, I'm going to have to go back
all the way across. Transformers in a car and drive underwater.
Well, I am a robot, so.
Yeah, so, you know, that's fine.
I can drive it.
It's not as if you use the internal combustion engine for things. You probably run on energy on cubes and. Oh, fuck, no. Decepticon. X Decepticon. Oh, bloody hell, where do they all come from?
Ah!
Well, there we go.
There we go.
It's a quick bonus game. There was Transformers. That's
right. I like it. I remember playing the demo and enjoying it.
Yes, there was some.
I think it's good.
Yeah.
Have you any other favourite Transformers games? We played
Devastation's good.
Devastation's good.
And War for Cybertron's good.
War for Cybertron.
I think they're the only two I've played, bar from the Ocean one from 1986 or whatever it was.
Yeah, and then there's all the movie ones, which I haven't played at all.
And nobody wants to play either.
Would you consider collecting all the Transformer games?
No. So there we go, some licensed games which are released way after the fact.
So you could release a licensed game now from any 80s TV, what would you go for?
Buck Rogers.
Buck Rogers. No thinking about it there.
We haven't talked about this before.
Yeah. We definitely need more Buck Rogers in our life. I would buy some Princess Adana DLC.
Definitely.
No question.
But yes, Battlestar Galactica, that was pretty good.
Yeah, I liked that a lot.
Enjoyed that.
I should play it some more.
Robotech, yes. Robotech. Yeah, that's the one. I've played that before. I played that through to completion. That's a really good game, especially if you're a fan of anime and mechs and things.
Yeah, I definitely need to look out for the PS2 version of that.
Yes. And then there was Knight Rider.
If you can get past the painful training sequence.
Really painful.
I think it'd probably be quite good fun. But
it's limited. Quite an effort. Limited. Yeah. But yes, and then there was He-Man.
Oh dear.
Yeah, that was dull, really dull. I mean, yeah. He-Man as a cartoon is really bright and colourful.
Yeah.
And this thing was 17 shades of shit brown.
Yeah. If you've got an itching for He-Man, I would just go and look at some pictures on the internet.
And then watch some He-Man.
Yeah. And bonus game, Transformers.
Transformers, yes. Yeah, pretty good.
Yeah, I like it, I think.
Very non-committal. Yeah. Yeah, so what licensed games have you played? Comment below.
Yeah, subscribe or naff off.
Boo, 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 fuck you,
that is going on your permanent record.